श्रीमते लक्ष्मी नारायण परब्रह्मणे नमः। श्रीमते हनुमत समेत लक्ष्मण समेत सीताया पतये नमः। श्रीमते श्रीरामानुजाय नमः। श्रीमते श्रीनिगमांत महादेशिकाय नमः। अस्मत् गुरुपरंपरायै नमः। अखिलात्मगुणावासम् अज्ञानतिमिरापहम् आश्रितानां सुचरणं वंदे नन्तार्यदेशिकं श्रीमद्रामानुजाचार्य श्रीपादाम्बोरुहद्वयं सदुत्तमांगसंतार्यम् अनंतार्यमहं भजे। नमस्कारम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी दी फोर्थ वर्स, meaning of the fourth verse of Sri Ramanuj Chatushloki and also the Phalastuti, and this recording would be the conclusion of the Sri Ramanuj Chatushloki Upanyasams rendered on the occasion of Sri Ramanuj Jayanti celebrations in the year 2021. The first three verses respectively, Anantan Pillai, Sri Anantan Pillai Acharya had paid his respects to the Murtis of Ramanuja in Srirangam, in Tirupati and Kanchipuram. In the fourth verse, Jaya Mahi Matandhakara Bhano जय बाह्य प्रमुखाटवी कृशानो जय संश्रित सिंधु शीत भानो जय रामानुज यादवाद्री श्रृंगे। यादवाद्री इज श्री मेलकोट। सो द फोर्थ एंड फाइनल वर्स अनंतान पिल्लई, श्री अनंतान पिल्लई ही हेल्स विक्ट्री टू यू रामानुजा, विक्ट्री टू यू रामानुजा। Even as you shine on the hills of Yadava or Melkote in modern terms, Bhagavad Ramanuja was such a towering personality. With his very attractive personality, he attracted followers of varied background. Even the learned scholars, they were convinced by the argumentative skills of Bhagavad Ramanuja. Those who belong to other schools of thought, they could not stand the argumentative skills of Bhashyakara, and thus they adopted Vishishtadvaita philosophy as their own. The Pamara Jana Pedayar Pesilum says Thiruvaranga Tamudanar in Sri Ramanujan Dandadi. Ramanuja was so compassionate that he would listen to even the dull and the ignorant. So thus they were also attracted by the compassionate personality of Bhagavad Ramanuja. Just like the sun would attract anybody, Bhashyakara was also a sun to whom Mayi Matandhakara Bhano. During the time of Bhagavad Ramanuja, there were many other schools of thought. Some, they claimed loyalty to the Shrutis and Smritis. Some, they were openly opposed to our Sanatana Dharma, like Buddhism, Jainism, etc. What did they all do? They all, with their own skills of argumentation, they had spread only ignorance and darkness everywhere. Bhagavad Ramanuja rose like a wonderful sun. What does the sun do? It removes darkness. Bhashyakara, what did he do with his brilliant works and his argumentative skills? He defeated all the other schools of philosophy who were spreading darkness. That darkness was removed, driven away by Bhagavad Ramanuja. Mayi Matandhakara Bhano. Mayi is to represent the Advaita school, which used the concept of Maya. So, not only Advaita Matha, which is very popular during Bhashyakara's times, but all the other schools of thought. If one studies the works of Bhagavad Ramanuja, like Sri Bhashya, like Vedanta, Sara, Deepa, Vedat Sangraha, very beautifully Bhagavad Ramanuja has delineated the understanding of other schools, and then very beautifully he has refuted their philosophies. So Jaya Mayi Mathandhakara Bhano. Bhanuhu means the sun. Bhano is the vocative case. Jaya Bhakya Pramukhatavi Krishano. Next, in the next line, Sri Anandan Pillai compares Ramanuja to fire. What does fire do? It burns all the, it burns everything, in fact. Teenil Tusagam Seppelo Rambhavai, says Andal Pirati. Jaya Bhakya Pramukhatavi Krishano. Krishanuhu means fire. All the other schools of thought, they had formed a dense forest, so to say, a jungle, which does not allow the sun to, or sun's rays to come in. So the entire world was put into darkness by these schools, who had spread everywhere like a forest with all forest wood, trees. Bhashyakara was like a fire which burnt all these, let us say, useless trees which were blocking the sunlight. So in the first line, in the first pada, he was compared to the sun. Second pada, he is compared to fire, a forest fire which annihilated, which destroyed all the needless trees and creepers and so on, so that it changed the world into a beautiful garden. When we don't take care of our garden, what happens is it becomes a forest. All the weeds and the unnecessary trees and the plants, they set in, they come from nowhere, and what they do, they eventually drive the good ones away. Ironically, what applies to the garden applies to our mind also. All the bad things, they come up very easily and they grow very fast. They don't require as much as, they don't require that much water and light as the good trees and plants would do. That's the ironical part of life. The same way, the other schools of thought which do not reveal the truth, which don't tread on the path of truth, they are able to convince people easily. So Bhashyakara, he descended as a divine fire and he destroyed all such weeds, which weeds means not small ones but big trees. He destroyed all the unnecessary and the trees that blocked the knowledge or sun's rays. Jaya Samshrita Sindhu Shita Bhano. If Ramanuja is compared to the sun and the fire, how would his followers would approach him? Because normally we try to avoid the sun and the fire. It does not give a very good feeling to go near the sun, go near the fire, especially in the, let's say, in the summer. In the winter, we may like to be in the sun. Just like how Bhagavan, with his two eyes, Sata Patala Bhishane, says Swami Deshika in Kamasikashtaka, that Imbrahman showed his anger to Hiranyakashipu through his one eye, and with the other eye, he showed his mercy or compassion to Prahlada. So that's why his eyes are compared to the sun and the moon respectively. In the same way, Bhashyakara is being compared to the moon now. Shita Bhanu is a moon. Samshita Sindhu Shita Bhanu. So to those who resort to Bhagavad Ramaja, he is like a moon now. With his cool rays, he pacifies the sufferings of his followers. And his own Sri Suktis, his works, which were like torching fire and sun to those who belong to the opposite schools of thought, to his own followers, it gives a lot of happiness. When we study Shri Bhashya or Vedanta Sara, Deepa, Veda Sangraha, etc., they give us a lot of happiness, bliss for us. Why? Because just like the moon, the full moon, which spreads chillness and also happiness, Bhashyakara, through his works, shines like a beautiful moon to his followers or to those who resort to him. Jaya Ramanuja Yadavadri Shringe. Such a Ramanuja, victory to you as you are giving darshan to us in Yadavadri or Melkot. Jaya Mayi Matandhakara Bhano. Andhakara Bhano. Ramanuja, victory to you who is shining like a sun, dispelling the darkness spread by other schools of thought. Jaya Bahya Pramukhatavi Krishano. Victory to you, Ramanuja, who is like the celestial fire, let us say, which destroys all the, or which clears the forest basically, which is filled with toxic trees. Jaya Samshrita Sindhu Shita Bhano. Ramanuja, victory to you who shines like a cool and pleasant moon, which gives happiness, which pacifies the heat to those who resort to it. In this case, the followers are the Shishyas of Ramanuja. Such a Ramanuja, Jaya Ramanuja, Yadavadri Shringe. Thus goes the fourth verse. And finally, Ramanuja Chatushlokim Yafpaten Niyatam Naraha Prapnuyat Paramam Bhaktim Yati Raja Padabjayoho. Very beautifully, Anantan Pillai, Acharya Anantan Pillai, very beautifully he gives the Phalastuti. Whoever studies the Ramanuja Chatushloki, whoever reads out, whoever recites it with devotion, what does he get? Prapnuyat paramam bhaktim. He gets he is bestowed with the highest form of devotion, where Yatiraja Padabjayohu, at the lotus feet of Yatiraja. Such is the Parastuti to Sri Ramanuja Chatushloki. Whoever reads or recites this Ramanuja Chatushloki, he does get highest form of bhakti in the divine lotus feet of Bhagavad Ramanuja. Ariyan wishes and prays that by rendering a short upanyasam on Sri Ramanuja Chatushloki, Ariyan gets the highest form of bhakti at the lotus feet of Bhagavad Ramanuja, and at the same time Ariyan puts forward this prayer and wish that anybody who studies Chatushloki, who listens to Upanyasam, should also get blessed with the highest form of bhakti. Dasan Ariyan Dr. Sri Ram Jagannathan, under the command of Bhagavatas, was given this golden opportunity to render short upanyasam in English on Sri Ramanuja Chatushloki. I am indebted to all the Bhagavatas. Dasan Dhanyavadaha. Srimate Ramanujaya Namaha. Srimate Anantacharyaya Namaha.